Welcome back. Drunk on Too Much Life is a deeply personal documentary that's been described as a love letter from the filmmaker to her daughter, Karina. The film follows Karina's mental health journey to find healing when psych wards and countless medications weren't working.
We're joined today by the director, Michelle Mellis, and her daughter, Karina. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having us.
It's great to see you both, and thank you for this film. It's so insightful. It's obviously very personal. And both of you really share your experience with Karina's mental health struggles. So, Michelle, I'm going to start with you. We're going to get into the film, but I want to get into the title first, Drunk on Too Much Life. Why did you decide to call the documentary that?
So the film is a love letter to my daughter, Karina, here. And she was such a beautiful and sensitive and creative child. And when she was about 6 years old, she started to worry about craziness and like, what is craziness? And, you know, she described what it means to be crazy. And she said, you know, being crazy is like being drunk on too much life, which is such a beautiful and poetic way to describe the kind of extreme psychic states and moods that she would later experience when she was an adult.
That's really a beautiful way to describe it. And Karina, in the film, you talk about how you've struggled with depression since you were 13, but that when you turned 21, things took a shift. So can you tell us a little bit about some of the symptoms you experienced, what you've been diagnosed with, and just what your mental health journey has been?
So it started off with like a lot of anxiety when I was a kid. So I was being really badly bullied, and then it turned into depression and like social anxiety and such. And then, you know, when I was 21 and I went to this camp, which was a catalyst for it, I would say, because of all the stress and feeling left out, it bringing up residual feelings from childhood, everything like that. I started hearing voices and was having delusions, and it turned into full-blown depression-related psychosis.
So what are some of the treatments that along the way you've been prescribed over the years?
I was basically put on like everything in the book, and finally they found the biomedical mix recently, like about a couple of years ago. That's what has been keeping me stable for a few years now.
We should all be participating in this conversation about understanding mental health. And one of the ways that we can participate is to think about the way we talk about it and the language that is used when we're referring to mental health and mental illness. And so, you know, when we're talking about language, the film, you know, explores reframing these illnesses as dangerous gifts. Can you explain that idea for us?
Part of our journey in the film is we interviewed this American writer and activist and clinician named Sasha DeBruhl, who was diagnosed with bipolar 1, which is what Karina had been diagnosed with. And he says that, basically, defining ourselves outside of convention, we see ourselves as having dangerous gifts to be cultivated and taken care of, like the wings of Icarus, instead of disorders or diseases that need to be cured or eliminated. And then he also says things like, I don't take psych drugs to control my mental illness. I take them to control my superpowers. Think of our whole history of philosophy, poetry, art, music really, I think, is touched by madness.
Karina, you had a personal experience involving seeing visions and your dad. Can you share that story with us?
I was in the backyard with my dad, and I saw two dark shadows basically sucking his energy or essence or whatever you want to call it. And at the time, I thought they were like something more sinister, but I just told him I saw these two dark shadows. Actually, the thing itself was quite sinister. It was actually lung cancer, because he was diagnosed 2 weeks later with like stage 3 lung cancer, 2 tumors. My parents and I both believe that I saw the manifestations of like those 2 tumors.
There's a lot of research between people that experience extreme psychic states and shamanism, or people or psychic qualities. It's not just purely a chemical imbalance, that sometimes these states can alter, like you're seeing into a different kind of reality. And these are, it sounds almost flaky, but there are Yale scientists that are studying this right now, actually many scientists that are studying this. So it does happen. And part of the message of the film too is that if we didn't stigmatize or discriminate so much with what gets called mental illness, that people, we would support them. It's the idea of dangerous gifts, that we would support them, and that then they wouldn't end up so extreme in the hospital or suffering so much.
Well, let's talk about support and the mental health system in Canada. In what ways is that system failing young people who need help, and what could be done differently?
We need more places where people could do things like art therapy for free, or like, I know it's asking a lot, but in an ideal world, this would happen. I've always been very creative and imaginative, so almost to a fault, because sometimes it's gotten me into trouble with the delusions. Mm-hmm. So the art therapy really helps me harness that side of myself in a very healthy, cathartic way.
In our experience, the psychiatrists are mostly giving medications.
Yeah.
It used to be where psychiatrists would actually talk to you. There was some form of therapy. Now it's just, they call it like a psychopharmacological look at mental illness, where it's like purely about a biological condition. And we find that framework too limiting in terms of a holistic healing, in terms of recovery. It's not enough.
So as far as the resources that are available to you at your disposal, what is it like maneuvering through the system? Because it sounds like there are things that are available, but it's hard to get to them.
I just feel as though you have to quote unquote hit rock bottom in order to access them, because then, you know, it's easy as pie to find a psychiatrist because they refer you to through the hospital and all that.
Like people are on wait lists for years, like, or even social housing, for example, for people who struggle. Karina's been on the wait list for 5 years, and she has 10 more years to wait. So that's the situation we're in.
Karina, you have a beautiful way of describing, you know, the path to healing. It's not a straight shot. It's not a straight line. It's a bendy, crooked, twisty road with lots of bumps. And the film certainly showcases a lot of those bumps. So my question is, how are you doing today, Karina?
I'm very well, thanks. I just got a puppy. I love animals. Her name is Callie, and she is 2 months old. I'm in puppy love, literally.
Yeah.
I got like a job working with seniors, which I've wanted to do for a while. So I've really been enjoying that. It's given me a real sense of purpose. I'm doing well right now. And, you know, I just want to say to everyone who's watching this, who's struggling or has kids with so-called dangerous gifts, there's always hope. And no matter how lost you may seem, like, I've gone through periods of time in my life where I've literally lost tons of friends, haven't been working, haven't been in school, like just literally in what felt like a limbo state of like not even knowing what the next day would bring and how sad I'd feel the next day. You know, there was always something I could draw within myself to keep going. Like, there's always hope in this life. And, you know, you're not a burden for reaching out for help. You're not a burden for, you're not weak for feeling your feelings. It's just, this life is complicated and everyone's complicated in their own way. And it's hard to maneuver these things.
Well, Karina and Michelle, thank you so much for connecting with us today. Drunk on Too Much Life is playing at the Rendezvous with Madness Festival. You can find out more information on in-person and virtual screenings on our social media channels. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.